breathlessly all over town. But he won't find me now, for I'm off coastward bound. And I'm trading the smog for some fresh salt sea air. And he'll never catch on that I'm there. Once was his apprentice in a clock-making trade, and the miser made me work for every penny of my wage, till he found he could replace me with a clockwork machine, and he threw me right out on the street. Him and left, and I solemnly swore that he'd pay. Now Mr. MacArthur has very poor eyes, and he never did see me when he left work at night. And once in a while he would forget to check that his workshop back window was closed. No, I'm not a burglar, and I'm no vandal, nor the old man had to suffer, but I wanted something more. I wanted him to feel it and know it was me, and I knew that his clocks were the key. I sat in his workshop, my thoughts running wild, and it suddenly hit me, and I looked up and smiled, for I knew that I'd have him, and I knew that I'd do it in style. There's a terrible strength in those tightly wound springs, and a gentleman's pocket watch stays by his heart, and that's where the damage can start. Now I'm no machine, but I can work when I choose, with hands good as any, when I've something to prove. So I stayed up all night among cold springs and screws, and I didn't stop till I was through. I rigged up a watch to do more than just shine, and I didn't balk once at the depth. Perfect invention that still kept impeccable time. He came to a messy and permanent stop. Now Mr. MacArthur's got blood on his hands, and he barely made bail. his downfall.